In Strange Academy, you have something that is rare in Marvel Comics, a perfect entry point.
It's the first day of school. It's the first year of a new school. It's gonna be a coming of age story with a bunch of kind of misfit kids from all around the Marvel Universe who have a proclivity for magic and sorcery and the mystic arts.
One of our lead characters is this young woman from the Midwest, Emily Bright, who has had little magical power since she was a baby. You meet Doyle Dormammu, an illegitimate son of the scariest magic villain of all time. All these characters from all over the Marvel Universe all dropped into New Orleans, where this school is set. All brought to you by Scotty Young and Humberto Ramos. It's so good.
I think Humberto is one of the best artists to depict kids. It's a real challenge to find that youthful nature, and he's so good at it that I really don't know if there's a more perfect person to do this book.
He was already the best in the business, and now he's upped his game times 10. It's just unbelievable what you see on the page.
It is definitely gonna be less focused on Strange. He's gonna pop in from time to time.
All the magic people in the Marvel Universe are all here. You got magic of the X-Men.
We're gonna micro-focus this on kids and what magic is and what the mystic arts are.
The Marvel Universe has never had a magic school, and there's a reason why. Doctor Strange never wanted to do that. That's why he'd always only train one person at a time. But something horrible is coming to the Marvel Universe, and if he doesn't help these kids figure out how to do what they can do, the whole world could end.
It's gonna be big and fun and magical and weird and exciting and all the things you want out of a Marvel comic.